The body works together whether you like it or not. Let's say we've got this pelvis. We want to adjust the position of it because it's tilted backwards. Something's kind of been yanking it down, so we want to mobilize it and make it go forwards. And let's say we do that, and we're going to look at this in a very simple two-dimensional way. It's always more complicated than this, but just for illustration purposes. So the body works in these simple pulling mechanisms a lot of the time. So as we drop the position of the pelvis down, as we essentially bring the pubic symphysis to a lower point, that drops down. Well, along with it, the muscles have to go too. They are lengthened because the distance between the higher point, let's say the xiphoid process or the anterior rib cage, the front of the rib cage, and the pubic symphysis, it's longer. So we generate a little bit of pull here. The abdominal muscles may lengthen, or what they may do is also pull down on this thoracic structure. Comparatively to the muscles on the back, as this comes up a little bit, they should shorten just a bit and allow for that motion. They'll take some of the pressure off this thorax. And quite likely what we're going to see is the thorax start to tip forward along with it. What we're making here is just a really simple circle. It's just circling around, kind of like that. Simplified, but it works. So what you really have to ask yourself, though, what you really have to ask before you're going to adjust anything is, does the thorax and lumbar spine, in this particular case, does it allow for enough movement for this tension change to happen, for this positional change to happen through its soft tissues or through its joint positions? And if it doesn't allow for that movement, if that movement is too limited, will that make it so that our change at the pelvis all the way down here either doesn't happen or is reversed slowly over time as they integrate and move their body? You know, soft tissues don't seem like a lot of the time. You know, they seem kind of unimportant, but there are a fair amount of them, no matter how you look at it. There's a ton of soft tissues running through the body, and they are what actually holds our bones and our joints up. They hold us together, and really, the bones are along for the ride in a lot of ways. Those soft tissues are very, very important. And now we can work this way up or down. It doesn't matter. Again, this is a simplified model, a simplified way of looking at things, but it still makes sense. As we change that position of the pelvis, we could say this side, the hamstrings, are getting longer, and comparatively, the quads are getting a little bit shorter, mainly rectus femoris, but that's okay. So we could work our way down, and we can even take it like a step down from there. As we change the position of the knee, and that last one, we change the position of the tibia on the talus, on the ankle, on the foot. Or, all the way up to the top, as we change the position of the thorax, we can change the position of the head and the neck, through the arm, and then all the way up into the head if you wanted to take it that far. So when you change one part, many other parts will be encouraged or asked to change along with it. This might take some time. Many of the times this is not an instantaneous effect. Some of the times it is, but it's not necessarily an instantaneous effect. But eventually everything will need to move, even just a little. So you have to consider whether the rest of your body will allow the change you want to happen. Doesn't mean you have to fix everything in the body just to fix one thing. It doesn't mean that. But you may want to consider looking at the mobility of everything closely attached to what you're trying to change the position of if you want to ensure lasting benefits from what you're doing.